Alright, here we go on our journey to destroy the condenser.
We inject you with a neural acid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did with your daughter.
It's too late, Jodie. It's too late.
Lima faccio, sale! Ma cartone, ti senti faccio!
I'm sick and tired of your stories! Jodie, this time you're really gonna get it!
Give me back my child!
Calm down, Nora!
I wanna see her! My little girl! My little boy!
For God's sake, what's going on?
The twin! He strangled her! We couldn't do anything.
I want to see my son.
Aiden. My twin. My brother. We couldn't leave each other. Our souls were bound together. I loved you and hated you for years. You were a part of me.
All right, let's see our choices.
Living, feeling, being in love.
I love you, Jodie.
Growing old.
I love you.
So many things I still have to do.
All right, that's option A. Let's see option B.
Universe. Being with Aiden and those I've loved forever.
All right, we're gonna go for the beyond just to see the ending. Let's go. See what happens if you go to the beyond. I feel bad for Ryan. We left him stranded. He's probably dead. Maybe not, though. I don't know. Let's see how big of a change this is to the storyline. Poor boy's freaking out. Where's Jodie?
Jodie.
Oh, we're dead.
Jodie, wake up.
Ryan ending was the best choice. He really cared about her. This ending right here even proves it. Yeah, the Ryan ending was the best one. But for the game, you were supposed to pick Zoe. So that way you had a partner in crime for the sequel that they never made. Alright, so let's see the epilogue now that we chose death. So, we are no longer in the land of the living. So, let's see how this changes the story.
There's a world out here. A whole universe of forests and lakes and mountains and rivers. It's all around us. You just have to listen carefully to hear its whisper. Neither heaven nor hell. There's no god or devil. Just a place where we continue to exist after we die. My soul explores it endlessly, and I've still only seen a fragment of it. I can be everywhere and nowhere. I can dissolve into nothing or become whole again. I can merge my soul with others or be more alone than any human being has ever been. All this is possible merely by the force of my will. I continue to look through to your world. I watch over those I love. I'd like them to know I'm there, that I'm okay. Hold them in my arms one more time.
Wow, Ryan became a scrub.
Tell them how much I miss them.
Dealing with death.
But I have the grieving process. Close by. Invisible. Transparent. No more than a fading memory.
Thank you.
I know what has been and what is yet to be. I know all the possibilities. I can see the darkness coming. I must stay a while longer. There is still a part to play before I can leave to discover what lies beyond.
Sometimes, I could spend hours staring into space, watching the images as they go by. They play over and over again, like a TV that's never turned off. I don't know why I'm seeing all this, but there's one thing I do know. It all really happened. When I'm alone, I listen to the voice inside my head. She talks to me. She says there are things I need to know.
Jodie.
Sometimes I shut my eyes and it's as if I could fly. I can go through walls.
Jodie became her Aiden.
And I discover faraway places without ever leaving my room. The voice told me not to tell anyone. I'm really scared. Especially at night when I'm alone with the shadows. There are things moving in the darkness. Strange noises. Whispers in the dark. The voice says it's nothing. That it'll all go away. But she won't tell me what these things are. And I'm too scared to ask. I often have the same dream. Everything seems so real. Sounds, smells, the light. Deep down, I know it's not just a dream. It's like an echo of things to come. I must get ready. I know there's not much time. There's only one thing I can be sure of. I will never be alone again.